Hey guys, it's your boy Prince, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where last off. To be honest, I don't remember because I've been away on holidays. This is my first Liverpool video since then, excuse me. And this game has some funny irony, doesn't it? Look at what game I'm playing. The exact game that was on earlier today. Hopefully it'll have a different outcome because I'm not in the mood to talk about that. That's a bit pissed off. So, just gonna focus on getting 3 points in this game. All I remember from the last episode is that I have a 14-point gap on second place, which I think is either Crystal Palace or Chelsea. I think it's Crystal Palace, which is weird considering they recently sacked their manager and now have shown they have no integrity by appointing big fat at rule breaker Sam Allardyce. Who in this game is probably still in charge of Sunderland, to be honest, because he doesn't sack managers. Regardless of how well or bad they're doing.
You're on your toes. It's one or two goals about for strikers.
Well, this is a real shuffling of the pack by Sunderland for this game. Billy Jones replaces Papi Meissan-Djoulibodji, who's been out of sorts lately. Seb Larsson comes in for Fabio Barini, who's disappointed recently. Jermaine Defoe,
sole striker today. Chris, I'm going to say David Moyes is in charge here. Right now. Oh, the Hood! Oh, that is just some luck. But the Hood, and myself will take that all day long. And it's 1-0. Sam, he's shook. It was blocked. The freaking man over here. Kind of thing. Trying to control it, hit the Hood, who slips it, takes the ball, and proceeds to slot it under, or I think that was Pickford, where it was Mignone in real life.
The team have some work to do because they've lost their last two games. They've got home advantage, and they need to win today.
Yeah, they do. Put pressure on them in front of their own fans, but I fancy them to do it here, actually.
Good challenge here. Trying to widen the approach play here. Out for a throw-in. Well read by the defender.
Come on, how did I not win that?
News from Alan McAnally from Selhurst Park.
It's a goal for Crystal Palace. 1-0.
Cheers, Alan.
Oh, Crystal Palace are playing Manchester City and they're winning.
It's looking good, this move.
Well, that's only going to mean that he don't go further behind me if they are the team in second. I skip past the league table before it could come
up. You in your prime.
Oh, too kind, Martin, but it was a brilliant header. Fantastic finish.
13, it's the right number, but that doesn't look like Pickford. Isn't Pickford ginger? I think it's somebody else. It could be something is a different goalkeeper entirely. Yeah. Before someone's markedly comments that I might be thinking Bogdan. No, I'm not. I know for a fact that he's not in goal for Sunderland.
Spotted that well and intercepted. And it's played to Jermaine Defoe. There's some potential in this move. Gets his foot in there.
Daniel Sturridge.
It's Mane.
Yeah, the 1-2 passing in between Sturridge and Mane. Hey, oh! Oh, it is Pickford. Huh.
Sebastian Larsson.
Am I thinking of somebody else then? Not because Warren Pickford was Jim. And had a lot less hair.
Shots on here. The shot gets blocked. And the referee spotted that deflection. He's pointing for the corner.
Oh, what was that? Go for the corner. For Matip! Straight Pickford.
Turn over to the opposition because of that poor touch. Used for you from Leicester, from the King Power Stadium, and Alan McInally.
Sturridge! Oh, that is just... It's the cheekiest... It's high level of cheek. The cheek meter is all the short. I don't know what I'm fucking talking about. I'm basically saying that was cheeky. I saw Pickford coming, hanging out, so him ball goes in the net. Pickford looks like a fucking asshole. Well, it's 3-0. Well, Daniel Sturridge having scored a goal in the real life game and then getting injured, thank you very much, Sunderland. And we'll send you his hospital bill. Oh, yeah. Fucks. Hey! Similar to real life for Sturridge and Mane. And it's a 4-goal game.
For Liverpool, it is looking pretty much now that the victory is assured. Oh, it's an enviable situation for them. Should be home and hosed.
24 goals for Sadio Mane. Putting him back in the lead after Daniel Sturridge's little display. Actually, I think Sturridge's second goal was his 24th, because his 23rd was his first goal.
And Jones.
So that means they're level.
Sharp piece of attacking play from Sunderland. Great chance! It was a good attack, a good effort at goal. If they are going to lose, they're going to go...
Well, down. The mark.
Yeah, I think the opposition probably know now that they virtually won this match. Coutinho. Well, they've got the ball back now in the middle of the field. And the time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Sunderland wondering whether they can go on and score from here.
Don't let him get the cross in. Ooh, but inadvertently, he did some fantastic defending. I mean, that was totally tense. That was complete fucking bullshit, to be honest. Let's see. Chelsea are winning. Man City equalized against against Crystal Palace. So far Chelsea are looking like they're going to get 3 points, and it looks like Crystal Palace will drop 2, unless there's a more to the tail in the second half, which there probably is.
He's coming
on with my so-called rivals are. They're screwing over themselves, and I'm completing a Daniel Sturridge hat trick. It's 5-0. Well, Daniel Sturridge completes his hat trick. One Sunderland player heads it away, another Sunderland player decides he'll head it back, and the ball actually goes in after the guy who initially headed it to the guy who headed it to Sturridge. Crazy stuff that, yeah. And Daniel Sturridge reaches a quarter of a century of goals.
Now Joe.
Before Christmas. Because this is the last game before Christmas. This game takes place on the 23rd.
Roberto Firmino trying to switch on the attack, and he could get away here.
Mane! Oh, Pickford. He didn't fall for it again, to be fair to him. I don't know why I tried it twice.
Rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other.
Chan.
Nathaniel Klein.
Nathaniel Klein!
Joel Matip. On the attack here.
To who? Put him in the pressure. Ah. Oh. Wait. Oh. Alaba's judged to foul Buckley as he was trying to get the ball.
Here's McNair. Possibilities for Liverpool.
Sadio Mane, Sturridge. 6-0. Well, Daniel Sir hit back his fourth goal of the game. And I think someone will beat.
It's a wonderful finish from a player.
I mean, if they could surrender, they probably would. And now is a good time to, as any, to introduce Moya Feor and Lopez. It doesn't even matter. I can put Lopez at CDM. And it won't even matter because I'm 6-0 up.
Freshening it up, Liverpool. With
this, they're going to get some good time on the pitch. They're going to get about 20 minutes. It's at the next stoppage of play, which is now, because again, Alaba's a judge to fouls the player where he got the ball from. Because why the hell not? I didn't pay any attention to who it was, but it'd be funny if it was Buckley again. Moya. Oh, man, tried to sneak one in at the corner. Mane! Pickford is equal to it. It'll be a corner, another corner.
And here we are, a double change coming up.
Jermaine Lenz and Defoe are both going off. Because, you know, fuck dudes whose first name... they don't get to play 90 minutes. And well, I'm kidding, of course, I have that turned off. Oh, I thought it was going to fall nicely to who? Holy shit. Pickford.
And the ball knocked away long. And in he goes with the tackle. Wahbi Khazri. Fabio Borini. Ten minutes left of regular time.
Come on. I'm not conceding a goal. That's one. That's the most important thing right now. Is to make sure the clean sheet stays intact.
Comes in now, and it's a header.
Oh, Sadio Mane, as well, let's add a miracle goal as well, because, you know, why not? And I say, all power to you. And Sadio, all power to you.
Well, another looking celebration, but inwardly, he must be buzzing. Brilliant. Well, coming in from the right, that was so inviting.
He's now level with that. Sturridge, as he scores his second of the game.
Could be dangerous. Abu Bakr. And now the shot! It is a goal for them.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. What happened there? Ball went through my dude. In this attack, he couldn't come up with the answer, having been left exposed yet again. No, I have to actually look at this again. I'm sorry. This makes no fucking sense. It's Sewell. He was right there. How did he miss the ball? And, no, good job, fucking Karius. Seriously.
Look at disgust from him and his defenders.
Piece of dog shit.
They've just left him.
I bet there's a lot of you saying, oh, don't be too disheartened, you're still gonna win. It's not like, I mean, that was a late winner or some shit. It's the fucking principles, you know? I don't like conceding goals, especially not against these cunts.
Promising build up.
I've conceded more goals against Sunderland in 2 seasons than I have throughout FIFA.
No, I think when you look at the way they knocked the ball about.
Okay, that didn't look like David Moyes or.
It was absolutely.
Or Sam Allardyce. I mean, maybe it was David Moyes. It didn't look like David Moyes. It looked more like Steve McClaren, if it's anyone. That's who it looked like. Oh, that'll cheer me up. Crystal Palace and Chelsea, both drop points, and Man City drop points as well. I don't even think they're up there. They're not. Oh, that's brilliant. That is fantastic. So, the gap is. Let's see. A win would take 17. 16 points.
Middlesbrough 2. Let's see what.
I mean, do we need to go on with this league season? Because it feels like we should. Because it feels pointless.
In third, Chelsea with 33 points. In fourth, Arsenal with 30 points. In fifth, rising up the table, are Hull City with 29 points.
Unbelievable.
Are Manchester United with 28 points. In 7th and falling are Leicester City with 27 points.
Really? In
8th, Newcastle United with 25 points. Bottom of the
table. That's just.
With 5 points.
I have no words for that. We have a game on Christmas Day. And it's against the other her team.
Climbing the table are Middlesbrough with 15 points.
From Newcastle. The team of the same name. Newcastle.
With 17 points.
They say 8 in the Premier League table. So the team. No, me. Is they like to be called older or in town. They want to get a bit of that wallopy that we handed it out to their neighbors. I say neighbors, you've never been to Newcastle. Well, I don't know how close the Stadium of Light is to St. James's. If you are English and are from Newcastle or support either team, let me know. Oh, because, I mean, any stadiums I know or that are like super close, because I've been there, is Liverpool and Everton, because they're.
Liverpool, they'll be looking for another win.
Everton are, like, almost literally across the fucking road. That's how fucking batshit crazy it is.
Well, it's not been easy for Manchester United since the departure of the great Sir Alex Ferguson. But they're down again on where they expect to be.
A lot of points still to play for, but they've been less than impressive, haven't they? Still time to make amends, but I don't know. A lot of ground to make up.
Bye from there.
This is the Liverpool side. Loris Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Mahmoud Dahoud plays with Emre Can in central midfield. In attack, Daniel Sturridge starts. He's got a hat-trick in the last game.
Oh my god, that's not the pass I was telling you to make, you fucking stupid.
There's good progress with this attack. Gonna try his luck.
Oh, thank goodness Karius saved it, because I would have fucking broke something.
Shots on here.
Tilty! Oh!
You can't do much about that when the ball bobbles up in front of you. It looks bad, but he's going to blind the pitch, I think.
Joel Matty. Throw in for Liverpool. This home team have been uncomfortable. Home.
Whoops.
Massive run that they're on and just want to keep it going today.
Luckily I got it back. I was going to say that yeah, was a huge mistake from me. It might turn good. Oh, my God. Can't put the ball in the back of the net. 25 goals. Who's this season so far? 34, 35 last season? And he couldn't put that in the back of the net.
The corner dealt with pretty straightforwardly. Out of play for a throw. Johan Gufran.
Oh. It's probably a weak claim, to be honest.
Daniel Sturridge.
Sturridge.
Time for goal!
Oh, to whose attempt is lashed into the body of Chancellor Mbemba and nothing more beyond that. Penalty! Ah! I was wondering why it wasn't. Why it was. Or something had been given! Oh, Joe Matip almost put me. He had the hood, can't get his show. And scoring consecutive matches. He's against the teams from Newcastle. Oh, Alaba. Goes for a goal! Foul, he was fouled. He was fouled after the show. What? Yeah, your man fucking Zidane'd that shit. Boom!
Challenge, that's good control. Short passes, they're keeping the ball.
Firmino.
Good skill with the ball to beat a man. That's good support play from his teammates. Comes in with a
Yes. I was going to say, I was trying to get past Colbert and lost the ball to him, but then went back. Hey, making that same and unnecessary. And go to his eyes, fuck it, I'll just lash it out of instead of, you know, getting it out of the box.
And here's the
The Hood! Ah, oh, unless Sells is probably going to... There, unless Firmino can stop him. Gives it to Tiote. Hey, Tovan and Yedlin. We have a little bit of a miscommunication. And I have the ball back. Coutinho wins in a throw off of Tiote. Here is Coutinho again. Nathaniel Klein.
Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of better things to come. And that will be Liverpool's. Nathaniel Klein. Good position.
I just realized I didn't even check to see if Crystal Palace and Co. were playing today.
Attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance.
They were still on 17 when I was coming into the match, which is why I'm on. Making this the halfway point, actually. Well, no, just the second to last game before that. So we're halfway. Hey, here we go. Palace are dropping points again at the moment. They're 1-1 with Swansea. And Chelsea haven't kicked off yet. Arsenal are losing, so they're going fucking nowhere. And saying that, I'm not winning either, so yeah, fix that.
And that's a pass that's gone astray, out of play. Chan. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Well, it's overhit, isn't it? And it's the goalkeeper's ball.
Come on, win the ball. Yeah, Nicholas.
Made the challenge well. Looking for an opening. There's a good control build-up.
Coutinho with the slide tackle of dreams. Yeah, it gives away the corner, but hey.
A corner not on the
ends. Things were perfect, right? Oh, Sayama, hey, use that pace! He's completely away from the defenders! Mane! Top corner! That's what we like to see. Sayama, hey, bags goal number 26. And the deadlock is broken. Don't look so pissed, Darla. Oh, it was bound to happen.
All over the place. Just no semblance of organisation from them.
It was always 1-0 as soon as I saw I was away, especially with Sadio Mane. He's one of the... He is... From an attacking standpoint, that is exactly who he wants to be. Running away from the defender is 1-on-1 with the opposition goalkeeper. Pretty much with the
supporters get excited about it.
Getting into a position where he has the goal at his mercy.
He can lay it off to the supporting player.
If he's a competent finisher, which Mane has proven himself to be more than on a couple of occasions. It was always 1-0. As soon I knew it. I was thinking as soon as I saw Mane was away. Yeah, I knew what was going to happen. We all know what was going to happen.
Emmanuel Rivière.
Any Newcastle fans watching this could have told you that was going to happen.
Second goal from Manchester City. 70 minutes played. 2-1.
Thank you very much, Alan.
Just to see. Their match isn't actually that important. This is the second season where Man City have played really badly. They were really out of it. It was one of last season. I'm saying that, there's no one in the title race except one team. That's the team that won it last year, Liverpool.
He's got support here.
Coutinho! Oh, with the save. You're going to bring off our friends here. I'm also going to bring on Divo Origi. Lopez doesn't need to come on.
Had to really reach out for that.
Good save from the Newcastle goalkeeper.
Shots on here.
Dude, hey.
Coming up another look at that save.
He's a master at getting his angles right, isn't he, this goalkeeper?
Hi, why not? Very handsome.
What about this impacting on their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Stoke after this, Martin. They've been below expectations out here. They need to improve.
Origi! Oh, he skied it.
Good chance that was for him. By his standards, that's the glaring miss.
Now it's 5 minutes to go. The return ball. Tried to tackle here, and he's done that. This could be a chance.
Where? Oh, before I could get it back to David Alaba, who was waiting in the middle like a striker. And he's my goddamn left back. He got the ball back again. And the hood. Fior! Straight at Darlow.
His team haven't been quite at it today, but...
Oh, yeah. He's upset that the match ended, so he kicked the wall at the referee. He's saying, fuck you, man. One nil. Not the biggest win, but I'll take it. Especially because my rivals dropped points again. Arsenal dropped points. Crystal Palace dropped points. Chelsea didn't even play. Didn't stop first. They dropped points. They lost. Chelsea lost.
Everton 2, Stoke City 2.
You know how I know they lost is because they didn't pass Crystal Palace. What a bunch of fucking nuts.
Manchester United 2.
Oh my god. What is going on?
2. Norwich City 1.
Can I have a competitive league title race, please? Is that too much to ask? It feels like that's too much to ask.
With 54 points. In second, Crystal Palace with 36 points.
Oh, yes.
In third, Chelsea with 34 points. In fourth, Arsenal with 31 points. In fifth, Hull City with 30 points. In sixth, Manchester United
just
with 29
points. Wiping it clean.
Leicester City with 28 points. In eighth,
oh, they drew.
With 25 points. Bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They were in 33, not 34. My bad.
With 14 points.
False alarm, Chelsea. You didn't lose. You just drew. They still dropped 2 points. So, that's some of this episode. Is it too early to put title, I have won the league? Because it feels like it shouldn't be. In the next episode, I will have games against Stoke and Manchester City. And probably going to extend my lead even more because Crystal Palace, Chelsea, Arsenal, no one wants to seem to challenge me. I mean, if the game wants to award me the Premier League title now, I'll happily take it. Same meal, I'll work. I say work, it's not really at work, much work, considering everyone else is doing the majority of it for me, which is always good. So, that is the end of another episode where everyone screwed themselves over, and I reaped the benefits. So, thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace.